Kia ora, good evening. There'll be a few frayed nerves around the capital tonight as aftershocks continue to rattle the Wellington region.
A severe earthquake sent residents diving and running for cover this morning. Luckily, there are few reports of damage or injury, but plenty of panic and fear. The 5.7 magnitude quake was centred 30 kilometres from Seddon near Blenheim and was felt as far away as Christchurch and New Plymouth. Joining us now live is Simon Bradwell. Simon.
Good evening. Yes, plenty of people heading into bars around here still talking about that quake this morning. And while Courtney Place is just starting to rock, this morning the whole town was rocking.
A traffic camera captures commuters streaming into the city when at 9:06 a.m. the 5.7 strength quake hits and the camera, perched high up on one of Wellington Stadium's light towers, shakes from side to side. Also high above the ground, crane operator Jeff Brooking.
Well, I didn't know what was going on at first. I thought it might have been just my driving, but I looked down and I saw the whole building moving.
Across town, the shaking was so bad it caused another crane to shut down.
How long have you been a crane operator?
15 years on and off.
Ever felt one like that before?
No. 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 It's hopefully never again.
What about at the top of Wellington's tallest building, the Majestic Centre, where $35 million is being spent on earthquake strengthening? Staff at Airways New Zealand found out.
Really just, oh my goodness, here we go. Is it the wind? No, it's not that windy. And luckily there were people with me.
Michael Stewart survived both big Canterbury quakes, so how did this compare?
To me, it was the soft end of the scale compared to what we've experienced out of Christchurch. My wife's up here and she experienced them both and was quite traumatised, so I was thinking about her, and her response was maybe a 10's coming, but hopefully not.
At Victoria University's Rutherford House, scenes of chaos.
We sort of just all like waited for a bit, see how it was going to go. Then it developed really big and everyone sort of freaked out then. So while my lecturer sort of dived under his desk, but I think that freaked everyone out a little bit.
Kids on this holiday program ready if another quake hits.
A bit wobbly. I was a little bit scared, but then because I didn't know it was an earthquake.
Commuters on the way home now, hopefully an uneventful journey.
All right, Simon, plenty of frazzled nerves obviously, but what about reports of damage?
Yeah, frazzled nerves, including my own, actually, thanks, Simon. Look, the EQC has had about 20 claims of damage from around the region. That's expected to grow. And look, the experts are also saying there's a risk of more aftershocks tonight and tomorrow. If that happens and you feel in danger, do what those kids do. Drop, cover and hold.
Thank you, Simon. We'll let you go and calm down. Simon Bradwell in Wellington.